DJ OTV. DJ OTV. DJ OTV.
Zazaky and wife regains freedom unconditionally as the governor of Borno State supports indigenes from the state in army recruitment, plus other news. The leader of the Islamic Movement of Nigeria and his wife, Ibrahim El Zazaky and Zenat El Zazaky, has regained their freedom after a court hearing at the Kaduna State High Court on the 28th of July 2021, which discharged and acquitted them. El Zazaky and his wife was arrested by the Buhari's led government 4 years ago and were charged to court on an 8-count charge of alleged culpable homicide, disruption of public peace and unlawful assembly, amongst many other things, which the Kaduna State government accused them of. On the 28th of July 2021, El Zazaky and his wife Zinat appeared in court alongside their counsel, Mashal Abubakar, who is the lead counsel in the suit. After the court hearing, Femi Falana, a senior advocate of Nigeria, announced that the trial of Sheikh El Zazaky and his wife Zenat has come to an end and they have been found not guilty of the alleged crime filed against them by the Kaduna State government and they have been discharged and acquitted. The court said that it discovered that the charges that were filed in 2018, according to a law that was signed by the state government of Kaduna State 2017, was over an alleged offense which was committed in 2015. Justice Gideon Kudara, who presided over the case, said that the charge was not supposed to be filed in the first place, as the government could not arrest someone for a crime which at the time it was committed was not an offense. But this is not actually the first time that a court is ruling that Ibrahim El Zazaky and his wife should be freed. The Nigerian army had arrested El Zazaky and his wife on the 12th of December 2015 and handed them over to the Department of State Services over an issue that ensued between his followers and soldiers who were part of the entourage of the former Chief of Army Staff, Lieutenant General Tukai Buratai. Earlier on the 2nd of December 2016, a federal high court in Abuja had ordered that El Zazaky and his wife be released unconditionally within 45 days. Justice Gabriel Kola Wole, who was the judge then, gave the order after he delivered judgment on a fundamental human rights enforcement suit filed by Ibrahim El Zazaky against the federal government of Nigeria. He had ordered that El Zazaky and his wife be paid the sum of 50 million naira as compensation, saying that the justification of holding him for his own protection was not sufficient. Also, in August 2019, another court in Kaduna State granted El Zazaky and his wife bail for them to be able to seek treatment abroad. But barely after 3 days, when the couple left the country for treatment in India, they returned due to unfair treatment meted on them by the security agencies that followed them. And finally, in 2021, on the 28th of July, a court in Kaduna State have ordered that El Zazaky and his wife be released unconditionally after discharging and acquitting them of every allegation that was leveled against them by the Kaduna State government. Nigerians have begun to liken the case of Ibrahim El Zazaky to that of the leader of the indigenous people of Biafra movement, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, stating that the government is only trying to replicate what it did to El Zazaky to Nnamdi Kanu. In another news, the Borno State Governor, Babagana Umaru Zulum, has said that its government was going to support 641 candidates at their final stage of the exercise to qualify them for recruitment into the Nigerian Army's 81 regular intake for the year 2021. The governor made this announcement while he was addressing the candidates at the Mia Malari barracks in Maiduguri. The governor was received at the barracks by Major General Christopher Musa, who is the theater commander of Operation Adinkar. While speaking, the governor of Borno State said that 641 candidates from Borno State were going to get a sum of 20,000 naira each after they have passed different stages of medical and fitness tests and are soon to leave for the military fitness exercises at the Fagor Game Reserve in Kano. From there, those who are successful will be recruited into the Nigerian Army. While commending the patriotism of those who chose to enlist into the Nigerian Army, Governor Zulum urged all candidates from Borno State to be good ambassadors of the state, adding that under no circumstances should any of them behave wrongly anywhere outside. And he promised that the government shall provide the needed support for all indigenes of Borno State. The governor also said, in addition to the 12.8 million naira, that he has also approved that 15,000 naira should be paid monthly to support each of the 641 candidates from Borno State during the last stage of the recruitment exercises. And has said that the government of Borno State will continue to do everything to ensure that those who chose to secure the lives and property of Nigeria, especially indigenous of Borno State, will be supported to the fullest by the government of the state. Meanwhile, the police command in Edo State has said that they have been able to rescue 13 kidnapped students of the Naval College of Engineering, Sapele, in Delta State. SP Katongs Bello, who is the police public relations officer in Edo State, narrated that the students were traveling in an 18-seater bus from Kaduna to Sapele when their bus was intercepted by hoodlums suspected to be kidnappers along the Ekpoma Bini Road in Rekme in East and West local government area of the state. He said that as soon as they got information about the kidnap operation, they swung into action and did all their best to rescue 13 out of the victims that were kidnapped. He said the following day, one of the victims came back from the bush on her own, while five other students are still with the kidnappers. He said that the police command in Edo State is doing everything within their power to rescue the remaining five victims. He also said that the news making rounds on the alleged kidnap of seven naval officers who were traveling from Kaduna to Delta State on the Benin-Sapele Road is false. He said that the report was fake, and the report further stated that the command rescued only five of the victims. Two of them are still with their abductors, and efforts are being made by the operatives to rescue them. He said that the police command in Edo State wishes to refute this fake and misleading news and is capable of fighting the Navy against the police and diverting attention of the two security agencies from doing their works of protecting lives and properties. The police command in Edo State have therefore enjoined the general public to disregard the fake and misleading news orchestrated by who they said are mischief makers who wants to set up the Navy against the police and create further tensions among commuters and motorists in the country. He said the command also wishes to assure the general public that those behind the fake and fabricated and misleading news will be tracked and made to face the full wrath of the law. He reiterated that 13 of the kidnapped victims who are students have been rescued, one returned on her own, and five of them are still with the kidnappers, but that the police is doing everything within its power to rescue them. So guys, once again, Ibrahim El Zazaki and his wife have been discharged and acquitted. Do you think they will be released from prison? They've been in prison for a very long time. Do you think they'll be released? And also, the Borno State government is making a move to support all those from each state who wishes to join the Nigerian Army. Do you see this as a good move that should be emulated by other governors? Drop your thoughts and comments in the comment section below.
Welcome back. Thank you so much for staying with us till the end of this video. But before we go, we just want to let you know that we're also on Facebook and on Instagram at DJMTV. Also, check out our website at www.djmtv.news. There we drop news 24/7 non-stop. Do not forget that you could also place your advert with us here on DJMTV News and be rest assured that your business will get to the desired market. Well, so we'll come your way again with another edition of DJMTV Daily News Update. I remain your host, Lauro Favor. Yeah!
DJMTV. DJMTV. DJ LTV.